Right, so this question came from IIT JAM 2016 paper. Now, before I move on to the question, I would just like to tell you why IIT JAM is important, okay? So, if you are thinking the reason of going into IITs is better education or better facilities, there is nothing like that, okay? I'll tell you honestly, from my personal experience, universities are as good as IITs. But the only thing that matters is that if you want to do your PhD or your postdoctorate from abroad, okay, then especially from US, then recommendations matter a lot, okay? So even though you have a average GRE score, what matters more is your recommendations. And since most of the professors from IITs have done their doctorates or postdoctorates abroad and they have collaborations with foreign researchers, so their recommendation is of high value. And you also know that abroad only the IITs are renowned, okay? There's no other Indian institute that is as renowned as the IITs. So it matters a lot if you get a recommendation of a IIT professor. So I think that is the only motivation for any student to get into IIT JAM. Okay. And for CSIR aspirants, it's very important for you to do JAM questions, because JAM questions, you know, they sharpen your basics. And that is also very important for cracking CSIR exam. Also, some questions from JAM are repeated in GATE, and some questions from GATE vis-a-vis are repeated in the IIT JAM paper. Now coming on to the question says that the correct order of pKa values for these four given compounds is, so one of them is phenol, then we have paranitrobenzoic acid, and we have acetic acid, and this compound, and these are the four given options, okay? Just ignore this for the time being, okay? Now how, so pKa basically measures the acidity. So the higher the acidity of a compound, the lower the pKa value, okay? Just remember this, the higher the acidity, the lower the pKa, okay? Now coming on to this compounds, now there are two ways by which you can find the acidity, okay? First of all, you can first of all you locate the most acidic proton. So over here, this is the OH proton, because they have the highest polarity difference, okay? Over here also OH, over here as well there's OH, and over here also this OH. So these are the most acidic protons present in the given compounds. Now there are two ways to find the acidity. Either you can go for the conjugate base, or you can, like I said, go for the polarity difference. Now if you see that in this compound, paranitrobenzoic acid, this nitro group is electron withdrawing group. So if an electron withdrawing group is attached, and this COOH, we can write it as C double bond O OH, right? And then we have a nitro group at the para position. So you see, this carbonyl group is already electronegative in nature, okay? And we have a nitro group as well, which is abstracting electrons. That is, electron withdrawing group is attached. So what happens is, this carbon becomes highly electronegative in nature. And because of this carbon being electronegative, it will pull some electrons from oxygen, and because of which there will be higher polarity difference between this oxygen and this hydrogen, because of which this compound will become the most acidic. Now coming on to the second option. This is acid again, acetic acid. Now if you compare, say, phenol with acetic acid, you'll see that in phenol, there's no electron withdrawing group as such which is attached. The conjugate base no doubt will be stable, because we'll get O minus, and this O minus will be stabilized by resonance. But if you draw the resonating structures, you will see that the electronegative the negative charge is on a carbon. And if you know if the negative charge is on a less electronegative atom, because oxygen over here is more electronegative, then this resonating structure is less stable, okay? But if you come on to this, if you draw the resonating structures of the conjugate base, then it will look something like this. So if we let me draw the conjugate base first. So this will be the conjugate base. Now if you draw the resonating structure, it will be negative charge will reside on the oxygen. So this is comparatively more stable than phenol. But there, like over here, there was an electron withdrawing group, but over here there's a methyl group, which will have some inductive effect. So because of which the acidity of this compound will be lesser than this compound, but more than the phenol. So we have, now I'll tell you what. Now, I don't know why, but some students, they tend to take out the acidity of all the compounds. Now say you will compare 2 and 1 also, then you will find out which is more acidic in 2 and 1, and then you will find out the given options. Now I'll tell you one thing, there's a smart way to do every question. Now if you have identified 4 and 3, now you know that 3 is more acidic than 4. That means 3 has a lower pKa, If 3 is more acidic than 4, then 3 has a lower pKa. So then just check for the options and see whether you can actually mark the option with the help of this. Now if you see the options 2, 1. Okay, now again here also I'll tell you the mistake. So 3 and 4, 3 is the has the lowest pKa. So if you compare, you see 3 has the lowest pKa. Can you see any other option with 3 as the lowest pKa? Yes, there are two options. One is B and one is D. One is D option. They both have 3 as the lowest pKa. Now what I said, the second most acidic compound is 4. Okay, so it will have a slightly higher pKa than 3. Now if you compare which option, option number B, because we have 4 and 3, right? So you actually did not have the need to solve for 2 and 1. You could just solve these two compounds and you can get the answer. Okay, so that's why never go for all the paths. Just try and solve the first two paths and then just see whether you can actually solve the question with the help of these two paths. Okay, now what students do is, see, if you see this option number C, 3 and 4. Now this is very smart by the IIT people. So what, now you'll say that 3 is the most acidic compound. So you'll go ahead and mark 3 as the most acidic and 4 as the a little less acidic than 3. And you'll mark C as the correct option. Now this is where most of the students make the mistake. In a hurry, you will mark this as the correct answer, but the actual answer is 2. Okay, so just be careful of such things. There will always be an option to distract you. So never, just, you know, have a calm mind and just think about it. So the higher the acidity, the lower the pKa, and so the option will be option number B. So 3 is the most acidic, hence the lowest pKa, followed by 4, followed by 1, and then 2. And the reason for 2 is that over here we have this group which is an electron donating group, okay? And because of this electron donating nature, this oxygen will, the polarity difference between this oxygen and this hydrogen will be very less, because of which this will be very not as acidic as this phenol, okay? Had there been an electron withdrawing group, say if we had this nitro group over here, then this would have been more acidic than the phenol, because now we have electron withdrawing group, which will increase the polarity difference between the oxygen and the hydrogen. Okay.